Hi, welcome to From V Maths in collaboration with FU Maths Solution. Today I want us to take a new topic which is still under Algebra 1, and this is what we call linear equations and inequalities. But before we tackle this issue, I would like us to see how we work equations with absolute values in them. And I think this will be of a great help to us in the future. So let's go to the board and find out how we work equations and inequalities involving our absolute values. Okay. Linear equations and inequalities. We'll start by taking equations with absolute functions in them. How do we work that? For example, having this equation, absolute value of x plus 5, which is equal to 4. How do we work such an equation? Because it is new to us and we need to know how we work this. The first thing we do is remembering that when we have an absolute value, let's say absolute value of x, is actually x or minus x because of the absolute value. If we have, for example, minus 1, the answer will still be what? 1. If we have 1, so the answer is still 1. So it may be either x may be of a positive value or of a negative value. So with that in mind, we can work our equations concerning absolute values. So we are going to get two solution sets for this because of our absolute value. So we pick the positive side, which will be x plus 5 equals 4. And at the same time, we pick the negative aspect of the absolute value, which will be negative x plus 5 equals 4. So we work them together and we have two different solutions. We place back into the equation to find out whether they fit or not. So working the positive aspect of it, we send the 5 there, becomes a negative 5, so that our x actually becomes a minus 1 for the positive solution. Now when we come to the negative solution, we send the minus, or divide both sides by minus 1, so that we get x plus 5 equals minus 4. So we have our x minus 4, we send the 5, x becomes a minus 5. So that x in the other case becomes a minus 9. Now, let's see whether minus 1 and negative 1 and negative 9 fit into this equation. We'll replace negative 1 here. The value here becomes 4. An absolute value of 4 is still what? 4. Also, when we pick negative 9, when we replace x with negative 9, we are going to get a negative 4. An absolute value of negative 4 is also what? Positive 4. This is why we need to take both the positive side and the negative side of the absolute value and work. So this shows that x minus 1 is a solution, x equals negative 9 is also another solution. Don't forget to work both sides. Okay. Let's take a second example and see how to work when we have two absolute functions or two absolute signs in one equation. So we're taking example 2. So we have x plus 3 absolute equals absolute of x, 3x minus 5. Here we can note that we have two absolute functions actually in this equation. So we have two ways of working this like we did for the first one. We take the positive side of the equations, then we take the negative side as well. So for our first one, we can pick the positive aspect to be x plus 3 equals 3x minus 5. Or what will be our negative aspect? Since we have two absolute functions here, we don't need to negate both. We only need to negate one of them so that we can get our function or equation solved. So you choose the one you want to negate, you can either negate the first absolute number or part, or you can choose to negate the second absolute number. They still provide the same solution. So I will choose to negate the first part. So I have negative x plus 3 equals 3x minus 5. Now let's work them out and find out whether the solution set to be having will be true or false. So we are going to get x minus 3x equals minus 5 minus 3. That's when we group like things. And we have minus 2x equals minus 8. So dividing both sides by minus 2, we are going to get x equals 4. Now let's work the negated side also. Expanding these brackets, we have minus x plus, so minus x minus 3 equals 3x minus 5. The negative multiplies 2. So negative 3x, that's when we group like terms. Negative 5 minus 3 goes then become positive 3. We actually have minus 4x equals the minus 2. Dividing both sides by negative 4, we are going to have x equals 1 over 2. So let's find out whether these two solution sets fit into our absolute function. When we pick 4, we place 4 here, we are finally going to get a 7. When we place 4 here, 4, 3 is 12, 12 minus 5 is 7. So absolute 7, they are the same. Using half also, when we place a half here, we are going to get 3 halves. When we place a half here, 3 halves minus 5 is also another negative 3 halves. But since the absolute value sign is there, it gives us a positive 3 halves. So they are equal. So these are two solution sets. Now we take this as your take-home assignment. Try your hands on that and it will help you understand the concepts better. So try to solve absolute value of t plus 2, which is equal to 3t minus 5. In working this, remember to place the positive aspect and negative aspect of the t. But since this t is not in an absolute sign, nothing happens to it. You have to take note of that. So when you work that, you can send us your solution for review and our problems to help you to solve that. We would like to end our introduction here. We will move on to linear inequalities the next time we meet for our tutorials. So we meet again. It's a very big goodbye.